kind of not only change but the metamorphosis is happening in India in the field of technology. I am truly amazed working as a minister and overseeing all this. I was just going to my Facebook. There is a young boy, Ritik, aged 14 years. And what he has said, I use Google Translate to learn Spanish so I can help Papa's foreign customers in our souvenir shop in Orchha in Madhya Pradesh. This is the new India happening. I thought I must share with you. Yes. Pradeep, a 30-year-old pawn shop owner from Udaipur, Rajasthan, uses his smartphone for trading of phones of OLX. His present phone is his 88th phone. His pawn shop also has a computer inside. What we as policy maker and you as a big business organization need to understand that the digital momentum of India has started. And what we have to do as policy makers is to facilitate that momentum to greater height, greater speed. And that is India. Digital India is something which we wish to be given to the posterity. And digital India, bridging the digital divide, is more for the poor, for the underprivileged. Digital India is ideology neutral, politics neutral, central state neutral. It is only India positive. Then all of us have to work there. The IT companies, the business bodies, the government, the NGOs, the civil society, and obviously the human being called Indians. All of us have to work. And the most exciting is the Common Service Center experience in India. And what is that? We have got 140,000 common service centers. Do you know 40% of India's railway ticketing is e-ticketing? 60% of air ticket is e-ticketing. And these common service centers are making passports, Aadhaar cards, electricity bill collections, banking correspondence, insurance deliverer. They collect about 1 crore 40 lakh banking transactions every day and 70 lakh insurance cover. I had 3-4 meetings with them. I was very excited. Now I am pushing them into e-commerce also in India. BPO call center in the small hospital towns of India. You see the digital profile of India, the geography is very skewed. I thought I must change it. We selected 48,000 seats. Distributed among all their states as per their census population. UP gets 88,000. That means 88 call centers. One call center, 100 seats. Bihar gets 44,000. That means 44 call centers. MP gets 35,000. 35 call centers, accordingly. We went for an expression of interest, and you'll be surprised to know. Against 48,000 seats, we got expression of interest by 78 companies, from 78 companies at 190 locations in India for 1,25,000. I pushed them into e-commerce, and their parcel revenue, which was dipped to by 2%, rose by 37% in 2014-15, and by December this year, last year, it has risen by 119%. I'm changing it completely because the postal department has got 1,25,000 rural post offices, a vast linkage. I'm going to also convert them digitally. I have asked them. We are giving handheld device to many of the post offices, 40,000 by March, and by next year complete. We are coming with a payment bank for the post offices, and about 60 plus companies are keen to partner with them. Therefore, these BPO's call centers, these common service centers, and my rural post offices being digitally converted will become the cutting edge platform of spread of digital media, apart from validation. We are in a big transformational program ourselves, namely digital infrastructure, whereby we are connecting all the Gram Panchayats of India by optical fiber network. When we took office, this program was there for the last 2.5 years, only about 358 kilometers have been laid. Now I can tell you, when last December, we have covered more than 1 lakh kilometers. And where we have laid the fiber, about 85,000 kilometers we have laid the fiber, and about 35,000 Gram Panchayat we have covered. I have given instruction to complete 50,000 by March, 1 lakh by this year end, complete by next year. And because we have also expanded the technology, we have taken the states on board. We are going to finalize the SPV very soon. I mean, 18 states have come forward. And the whole idea is to have fiber from district to block, block to Gram Panchayat. Digital village. The idea is to select one block in every district of India. Pick up one Gram Panchayat in that block and ensure a center to have Wi-Fi connectivity, to have a virtual class, and thirdly, connect the primary health center with the district hospital, digital technology, and have a big LED light in the center of that village with power, solar power. Now, these concepts are going to further strengthen the entire initiative. And what I foresee is, as I see the unfolding of technology, if one Gram Panchayat is doing well, I want competition to happen among other Gram Panchayat. Yes, we are giving a lot of emphasis on e-governance, various government programs. What our Prime Minister always says, I want governance to be available at the palm of every Indian. And this e-tal is basically designed as to how many government services, state or center, are being pursued by the people. All the government transactions are available at a click of a button. In 2013, 2 million people were using it. 2014, 3.53, and 2015, 6.95 billion people. See the rise of it. Strong emphasis on e-education. We are expanding our footprint of higher education. How can the virtual classroom by recorded lectures and others can be encouraged? That is, I foresee a big area of excitement and growth coming in India in the future. All these institutes digitally connected will have a lot of initiative from these experienced professors whose digital classes would become a big draw. Then we have to work together with HRD and the state governments. Digital health. With Apollo, we had done a pilot program of 600 districts with common service centers for digital diagnosis. These initiatives have to grow further. And I'm very happy that many of them are doing this. I'm happy to tell you that when I became minister, about 11,000 crore plus investment proposal has come. And when last year ended, we have received proposals worth 1,17,000 crore. That's what we are looking at. And all the big companies from Foxconn to Samsung have come into India. Many have started operations, many are expanding it. From manufacturing to infrastructure to innovation, all have to work together. And therefore, a digital India, a skill India, Make in India and Innovative India, Stand Up India, all have to work together. And that's how we are working.